Tell me how you're not a cool one. I'll keep you get the points. Everyone, and welcome back to another video. What you just saw is a little cinematic I have been tinkering away at, and it shows you some of the progress of Shin-Machi over the past few months. The aim of today's video is to show you some infrastructure builds in the form of time lapses, complemented by some before and afters like you just saw and some cinematic shots. So without any further ado, let's get right into it. For context, here's a little backstory. The city of Shin-Machi literally means new town. It gets its name from Wan-Machi, the old town named for its position along the bay. It has experienced tremendous growth and is in dire need of transportation infrastructure. In the few months since the old shots have shown, the population grew from about 200,000 to 330,000. Along with it came railway expansion at breakneck speed, both metro as well as mainline networks. The builds covered in this video are the finishing touches of the bay bridge connecting Umenote, the artificial islands district, to the ring motorway, along with the arterial that connects the bay bridge through Sankandai and up to the unfinished ring motorway. This section will involve a major cut and cover tunnel to allow for shipping access. Ah, wonderful. Now that the Bay Bridge is properly supported and abides by the laws of physics, my heart can rest easy. And with it, we can move on to the next project. The arterial expansion and tunnel excavation takes place further down the road, past the elevated expressway and beyond Sankandai. You can see the old path of the road in this video clip, but it's about to change big time, so hold on to your hats, fellas. Thank you. So as you can see, I use the landscaping slope tool quite a lot to ensure that the curve and slope of the tunnels are consistent with no weird ups and downs. Even though you can't see them once they're buried, it's still nice to know that it's done well and proper. And as you can see in this video, courtesy of my government, the method also resembles real cut and cover construction quite a bit. Even though in real life they would use something like sheet piles as dams instead of huge swaths of soil as I have. Then, once the tunnel is done, it can be covered by the riverbed and finally remove the sheet piles to return the water to its original state. Now, enough talking and let's see the final construction time-lapse of the three interchanges. With the end of the final time-lapse dawning upon me, I have to say I'm really happy with the result, and I hope you can all agree. However, that takes away a little praise from editing the closing segment, which took more time than all the builds combined. If you made it this far into the video, congratulations, you're about to have a treat.